If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay, student, let's continue from our last class. So in last class we have done up to DTOC, that is page number 22. So we will start with from there, and we will start from IDMT relay. So what is IDMT relay? This one, it is inverse definite minimum time relay, and it is the most widely used overcurrent relay because characteristics is inbuilt in inherent characteristics of electromechanical relays. So the both the characteristics matches, so that's why it is widely used overcurrent relay. Now you can recall your electromagnetic relay that we have studied in our last class, where we have how electromechanical relay, one induction based relay we are talking about. There we have taken two different fluxes, phi 1 phi 2, having a phase difference between these two fluxes, due to which two eddy currents was flowing, and due to that interaction F1 and F2 was created, and the difference between them was the driving force, which was directly proportional to I square. So in the figure also, in the coming figure also, you will see there are two fluxes produced. How they have produced? There is a shedding coil. Shedding coil, you can remember, shaded pole motors, shaded pole in your machine course, you can remember. So there is a phase shift between phi 1 and phi 2. You will see the figure after some time. Now first you think, what is low PS? Low PS means, from the formula you can say, low PS means what is the threshold value you are setting. So if you are setting a very small threshold value for a fixed fault current, it will look a severe fault current, which in turn will create a strong flux and vice versa. More current means more flux. Let me explain it one more time. Suppose you have set a current of 5 ampere, say that is your flux setting. Now there is a suppose fault of 10 ampere. Now what is your PSM? 2. If your flux setting was not 5, was 10, then what would have been the PSM? 1. So low PS value, as you are decreasing your flux setting, suppose your flux setting is now 2. So fault current is 10, fault is same, so but the PSM will be 5. So if you set it at 2 and if you set it at 5, what is the difference? If you are setting it 2, the same fault will be treated as more severe fault, because you thought that 2 is my threshold, anything above 2 is fault. So it is 10, so it is much above 2, so it is a severe fault. If my setting is 5, then my setting is 5 and the fault is 10, so it is more than 5, so it is severe, but it is not as severe like earlier case when it was more than 2. Now you got it, na? So that's why they are saying low PS means a high severe current. So it should turn, it should give more fluxes, so that in case of more severe fault, the fault should be clear more fast. Very fast it should be cleared. So more flux should be created. Once you see figure, it will be clear for you. It is coming. So low PS, again, low PS refers to high PSM value. PSM value will be high. Hence, high PSM should refer a low operating time. So if your PS is low, so your fault current will be treated as severe fault. Therefore, your PSM will be very high, and your operating time in that case should be low. So you will see whether all these characteristics are satisfying. Let us see the figure first. Now you can see here, these are the two fluxes I was talking about, phi 1 and phi 2. Here you can see the shedding coil. These are not just a shorted copper bars, which are connected across pole to create the phase difference between phi 1 and phi 2, like in your similar to your shaded pole concept. And this was your through which your CT secondary current, that is fault current, is passing through. And here are the plug settings. You can remove one plug from here, you can connect it. As you connect it, as you proceed to the upper portion, your plug setting increases. How it increases, we will explain. So if you are going in upper portion, that means you are reducing your turn. You can see this one. You can see you are virtually shorting this one. Suppose if you are putting it here, at 3, that means how many turns you are having? Only 1 or 2 turns. After that it is directly grabbing and then going. You are getting it now? If you are reducing that plug, if you are reducing this plug, that means you are getting much more turns. If you are going up, you are getting small turns. So that is the plug setting through where we can set the threshold current. How it all operate will come. Let me explain first all the parts of it. Now this was the aluminium disc I was talking about. It is rotating. It is a 3D. You can see the backward is this one. So it is a disc. So this is a disc which is rotating here. This one, the thing I am talking about. This is the disc that is rotating here. Okay. This is the core, iron core. Okay. Next what? Next is these are the trip contact. If this movable contact touches this, then trip circuit is short circuited. So it will rotate and once it comes there, it will touch that contacts, this contact, and then it will be get shorted. Now what is this control springs? Control springs, these are spring connected to the this moving portion, it is connected to this. Why? With the aluminium disc it is connected. As it rotates, suppose there is a fault, it will trip, it will rotate there, it will strike the trip contact and it will remain there. You want to bring it back to its original position. You want to make it ready for next fault, because it is done. Once it is given trip signal, then its job is done. It should come back to its original position so that it is ready for next fall. So how it will come back to its original position? If you use a spring, so it will rotate against the spring, and once the job is done means trip contact is given, that means your current will be, this current will be zero, because line is out now. So once this current is zero, the phi is zero, this means the force driving it to rotate, that will be zero. So it will remain there if someone doesn't pulls it back. So who will pulls it back? That is the control spring. That is the spring action which gives the control torque, which will operate against your operating torque. This is your backstop. Backstop means where the disc will stop going back, and next time it will start from here. That depends on TMS dial adjustment. That is your time setting. If it rotates full, then it will rotate full. That is 1 TMS they say. If it is 0.6 TMS, that means the disc is given not full rotation, it is given at 60%. It will advance by 60%, it will be somewhere here, and from here it will start. If it is 50%, it will start from 50%, then it will start. You are getting it now? One more time. Suppose it is 1, this is full rotation from here to here. Suppose let. So if it is a 50%, then the backstop will come here. You will set it in such a way that this backstop comes here. So next time it will start from here only. So it will take much less time. So this is your time setting, TMS setting. Now what is this permanent magnet? This permanent magnet, this is nothing but damping torque. What is damping? I think you have gone through damping in your machine classes. If you have not, I am explaining one more time what is damping. If you see a coconut broomstick, if you move it in air, it will vibrate. It will go from this side to, suppose if you want to take it from A to B, let me draw it in a blank place if I have anything. So that, suppose this here I am drawing. Suppose you have a bamboo broomstick, you want to move it from A to B. So while moving, it will vibrate. It will vibrate, then it will go. It will vibrate in air. So that means there is a lots of vibration while going from A to B. It will vibrate. Even reaching B also it will vibrate for some time, then it will settle down. So this is damping. We don't want this. We wanted the transition should be smooth. The movement should be smooth. This vibration will not, we don't want these vibrations in any rotating devices. That's why always a damping concept comes in. So if you place it in water, suppose now if you are moving it in water, in a pond you are moving that stick from A to B, it will not vibrate that much, because there water will act like a damping. It will damp out the oscillations. So here this permanent magnet do this job. How this do this How this one is solving the damping purpose? Because it is a magnet, so if you are vibrating that one too much, that means your magnetic field is changing. If it's changing, then there will be induced EMF. And because it is Dicks, so again the Dicks will treat like a short-circuited path. Dicks itself, like the eddy current flows. The same concept, the eddy current will flows on the Dicks, on that portion, on that Dicks. So what this current does, it is a, by Lenz law, it is a mother killer. It will try, it will find out what is its origin. So from where it is coming, this current is, this force is coming through eddy current. Eddy current is coming through the EMF produced it. The EMF produced it, why? Because it vibrated. Because it vibrated, so there is a lots of change of, change is very high, rate of change is very high, that's why it came. So it will try to, the force will try to oppose this rate of change. That means this movement, it will try to, the first movement, the vibration, it will try to stop, and then it will damp out the oscillation. So this is the damping torque, which will be against the operating torque. It will also slow down the operating torque, it will also stop to move that. So that is against the operating torque. And it is directly proportional to d theta by dt. That is the rate of oscillations of this movement. Theta is the angle. Theta is this angle. How much you are at a distance you are keeping the backstop. Your spring constant, control spring depends on that theta. If you are making it full rotation, that means your spring will be, when it's rotated, that spring will get much compression. It will give more force. So your control torque will be more. So it is directly proportional to theta, and your damping torque is directly proportional to d theta by dt, rate of change of theta. So now if we continue with this one, we'll try to derive some relation between them, operating time of this one. So low TMS, time multiplier setting. Oh, I was talking about why these plug settings are above, if why it is going in upside, higher plug setting, why it is going in upside. Now let me explain. These Dicks, everything is fixed. You have fixed this one, you have fixed backstop, everything is fixed, suppose. So now the Dicks will rotate for a particular phi. This value is fixed. For a particular, if the phi is more than that, then the Dicks will start rotating, your force will start make it rotate. So that force is depend on phi 1, phi 2 and angle between them. Angle is fixed by shedding coil. So it depends on phi 1, phi 2. Phi 1, phi 2, let it be fixed for some value x. For some value x, this phi will rotate. This phi, anything above that x will make the Dicks rotate phi. So what is this x? This x is depending on, what is this x? This x is phi. That phi comes from, suppose, phi comes from a magnetic strength. How much strength you are imposing from this side, which is nothing but Ni, ampere turn, number of turn into I. So your phi will depend on this Ni. Because your phi is fixed, so Ni is fixed. Anything above that. So if your current is, if you want to set it for more current, that means your number of turns should get reduced. A less turn with more current give the same flux. A more current will need less turn to give the same flux. And reverse, a less current will need more turns to give that amount of flux which will make it rotate. Now you are getting it. So you need it, if you need it that it should go, if it is more than 3 it should trip. You want to set it at 3 ampere so that anything above 3 ampere it should trip. So your Ni should be fixed. Because you have increased your I for 3, your N should be reduced. That's why it is going upside. I think you got some idea. Now, what is low TMS? That's what I am saying. Low TMS indicates the less distance between movable and trip contact. That we have seen, how much far you are keeping the Dicks. If your TMS is 1, means you keep it at a full rotation. It will take the full rotation, then it will hit. If it is at 50, that means it is at half rotation, then it will trip. Therefore, low TMS will indicate quick relay operation. So if your TMS value is low, time of operation will be high. We know, we have already discussed this one last class, T operating is directly proportional to I square. Operating means that driving force F. The control strings provide the control torque, which will depend on the angle theta, how far you are kept it. If you kept it full rotation, then if you rotate full, the spring will get more compressed, the torque will be, control torque will be more. So control torque directly depends on theta. Next is damping torque. The permanent magnet provides the damping on which it, so damping, T damping is depends on d theta by d delta by dt. How much first the angle is changing, that means the disc is rotating. At the verge of operation, these two are equal. T operation equal to T control and T damping. So if you now you know the formula, let me zoom it. Now you know the formula. T operator is directly proportional to I square. So you have given a constant K I square. T continuity is the S delta. T control, delta, it will directly proportional to delta, control torque. So S is the spring constant. D is the damping constant, because damping is directly proportional to d theta dt. Now this become, what does this become? This is a first order differential equation. If you solve it in your maths, you can easily find this is the answer. I am not solving that first order differential equation because it will take more time. So your theta will be something like this. Here, what is AB? AB are the constant. It will be the function of this K, S, D and this I. Now for solving differential equation, you need some initial condition. Now what are these conditions? These two are the condition. At the starting, T equal to 0. What is the value of theta? Theta is the value of theta 0, some fixed value. That is, it is, so it will depend on TMS. If your TMS is 100, then it will be 360 degree. If it is 50%, then it is 180 degree. Now at what? At the operating time, at T equal to full operating time, it is operated. What should be delta? Delta will be 0 because it touched the contact. No angle is, angle is the how far it is from the trip contact. If it is 0, that means it directly came and touched it, and the operation has been done. So if we put all these conditions here, we can have a relation between operation time and I. If you put, T operation will come here and I is already there. So there will be expression between T operation and time, I. You will also get TMS there, because theta 0 will give you the TMS. From I, you will also get PS, flux setting multiplier, that is PSM. So if you put everything there, finally your equation becomes, by proper designing, now you can design your spring constant how much, your damping how much. So all these constants you can vary. So it did vary, and core saturation phi, that everything you can vary. K, S, D, all three constant parameters you can vary. So from that you get, we get these three different characteristics of IDMT, three different types. One, we know normal inverse, this is this one, which is IDMT, that is inverse definite minimum time. You can see if your TMS is increased, then your time of operation is increased, because TMS is increased means you are going far away from the tip contact, you are taking full revolution. You can also see if your PSM is increasing, then it is decreasing. How? PSM is increasing means more severe fault, though time of operation should be less. Now in case of very inverse, it is this one, more the constant value is increasing, because time of operation you need very inverse, means it will be, for more current it will take more less time, the current will be very time taken will be very less. If you draw the character, if you see the characteristic, then it will be easy. Extremely inverse, it will take 80 TMS. This 80, 13.4, these are all depending on the constant K, S, D, how much you are taking. So if you are plotting it in the graph, you will see this graph as, if you see this graph as, this is the relay current and this is your operating current. So these three cards, the first one is the IDMT, you can see this one. Next, this is inverse, this is very inverse, is going like this. Let me not draw it there, you can see it, I think, easily. So this is IDMT, this is very inverse, this is extremely inverse. Now how all these represent to BH curve? You can remember this BH curve. We have already told that protection density always works around the ankle point. The, because you can see the extreme inverse, in case of extreme inverse, the this portion, this inverse characteristics is nothing but, if you are increasing I, that means current is decreasing, which is actually this portion. If you are increasing I, then your B is increasing, flux is increasing, more increased flux, less time. So the one that is very inverse will try to explore the maximum linear portion of this one. so that it have maximum inverse characteristics. You are getting it? One more time. The very inverse, you see, it is taking the maximum linear portion, so it will get maximum inverse characteristics. The IDMT is taking minimum, smaller linear portion, that's why that inverse characteristics is small here. So how you are exploring that BH curve, that from where it depends your IDMT inverse and very inverse, which is nothing but your K in the constant, how you are changing your K. So I think that's all for today. This is the IDMT characteristics, different types of relay. Next day we will start some numericals.